Hello everyone, my name is Lil and I'm working for FFG as expert for European research funding. For the next minutes, let us have a look at the features of the Global Fellowship. You already know that the Marie Skłodowska-Curie postdoctoral fellowships are for researchers holding a PhD to fund research projects in any scientific area. There is no age restriction, but there is a restriction of the scientific age of the researcher. And you know that the researcher has to go for the project abroad. Now, what are the specificities of the Global Fellowship? First, the nationality of the postdoctoral researcher is relevant for the Global Fellowship. The researcher needs to be a national of an EU member state or a country that is associated to Horizon Europe. Our researcher, Dr. Marie, is Swedish by nationality, so she can apply for a Global Fellowship. In particular cases, also nationals of third countries can apply if they are considered long-term residents, which means that they have spent at least 5 consecutive years in Europe. For example, a colleague of Marie, Dr. Miguel, is Brazilian, but since he has spent more than 5 years in Vienna, he would be considered a long-term resident and can also apply for a Global Fellowship. The Global Fellowship is of interest if you want to spend a longer period outside of Europe for your research project. And with longer, I mean between 1 and 2 years. So this can be much longer than in a European fellowship. This long period spent outside Europe is the reason why this fellowship type is called Global Fellowship. And you see the setup here. The Global Fellowship is a joint application between the researcher and 2 host organizations, a host for the outgoing phase outside Europe and a host organization in Europe called the return host for a period of 1 year. In both cases, the host organization can be from any sector, can be academic or non-academic. Dr. Marie would like to plan her Global Fellowship with a university in the US, and she wants to spend there 2 years. For her 1-year return period in Europe, she plans to stay at a research institute in Austria. So overall, her fellowship is for 3 years. Also important for you to know is that throughout both periods, the researcher will be employed at the return host in Europe. So in the case of Dr. Marie, this would be the research institute in Austria. And please mind that there are specific conditions if your fellowship is in nuclear research. You can see them on the slide. And if you're unsure about this, please get in touch with us. Now, let us have a look at the mobility rule. The mobility rule for a Global Fellowship relates to the country where the host organization for the outgoing phase is located. So in the case of Dr. Marie, the US. Please remember that the mobility rule is a strict rule, and before you start developing your project, please do check if you comply with this rule in relation to the country where your host organization for the outgoing phase is located. So in the case of Dr. Marie, she needs to look at her CV and see if she has spent time in the US during the 3 years before the call deadline. And if yes, would this be within the limits of the mobility rule? So not more than 12 months. Dr. Marie has been to the US before while she did her PhD. And when looking at the exact dates, she realizes that during the 3 years before the call deadline, she has actually spent more than 12 months in the US. It's only a few weeks, but it means that she cannot apply for a Global Fellowship with a host in the US, and she has to consider her options from scratch. Maybe there is a research institute as interesting, but in another country outside Europe. Or should she go for a European fellowship and plan a secondment to the US? Although this would be much shorter than it could be in a Global Fellowship. Well, whatever Dr. Marie decides, let us return to some more features. In addition to the basic setup with an outgoing and return phase, you can also plan secondments and involve even another organization, which can be located anywhere in the world. But keep in mind that such secondments can take place only during the outgoing phase. For the one-year return phase, you need to be at the host organization only. Apart from secondments, you can also plan short visits for all sorts of purposes. And after the return phase, you can also plan an additional placement in the non-academic sector with a duration of up to 6 months, which means that the duration of a global fellowship can be up to 3.5 years. So the idea, just to remember, of the additional placement is to provide an incentive for postdocs to spend time in the non-academic sector and discover career options also there. It can be with an organization anywhere in Europe, including the country and city where your return host is located. So looking at all the options, you see that a lot is possible. And with that, I think it's time for you to think about it. Is the Global Fellowship something for you and your research idea and your plans for the future? Or is it rather a European Fellowship? Whatever you decide, I wish you good luck for that. Have a nice day and goodbye.